Hello, I'm Craig McGee, CEO and founder of Panoptic Events. This is the Event Makers Podcast, and this is Gran Canaria. We are Panoptic Events, and we've always had education at the core of what we do, and over the last few years we've decided to focus more on the gaining and sharing of this knowledge. In the last 2 years we've been to over 200 destinations around the world in order to let you know about the best destinations for MICE events. This month we've decided to head to Gran Canaria for the second time in order to find out about the MICE industry and the experiences of this very diverse island in the Canary Islands. Sit back, enjoy. Let's go meet Sergio.
Sergio, my amigo. Welcome to the Event Makers Podcast.
Thank you very much, my friend. Thank you very much.
So good to be back in Gran Canaria.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure having you here. It's a pleasure having you here.
Fantastic. A bit of music. What
have
we got here?
We are enjoying the art of my personal friends, Juan Sebastian Ramirez, and his right arm, with this small ukulele-like, cavaquinho-like, local small guitar called timple, which is a regional instrument of the Canary Islands, right? Timple. Yep. This sound connecting with the most iconic location in Gran Canaria, Roque Bentayga, Roque Nublo, you know, to people feeling the island, give us like a goose pimples, right? What we are doing now here is trying to include the tradition, gastronomy, in this very special venue. So we want everyone to enjoy what we are feeling now here in Gran Canaria, right?
We've got the weather, we've got the music, we've got the food, we've got the wine. Can you do me a favor?
Please remember, Craig, sorry to interrupt you. This is December.
I know.
This is December.
What date? 16th of December, T-shirt?
December. Canary Islands, Gran Canaria.
I'm from Scotland, right? Mm-hmm. I've got factor 50 on, as we like to call emulsion. I need that in December.
I mean, we are in the heart of the UNESCO protected reserve of the biosphere. This area is known as cultural landscape of the sacred mountains of Gran Canaria, where the ancient civilization, the old Canary people lived before the arrival of all cultures coming from everywhere. This is a cultural crossroad.
Nice
crossroad between Africa, South America, and Europe. So this is like a hub of culture. We are like a meeting point for culture in the heart of the Atlantic Ocean.
We'd certainly feeling that. I've got an idea. Normally I would just interview you in one location, but I'm thinking, what if we went a tour around the island and we spoke about different areas? What do you think about that?
I am so happy about it. This is about to start. Yeah. Let's go around a journey discovering Gran Canaria as a great place for events.
Let's go and discover Gran Canaria. Let's do it. Gracias, mi amigo. It's been quite a journey so far. Been great, obviously, just been up and seen that crater.
Yep.
Beautiful, beautiful. I mean, like, but this is one thing I love about Gran Canaria and Spain as well, the small towns. They're incredible. The small streets, the beautiful doors. Where are we?
This is San Bartolomé de Tirajana. This is a place we call Tunte in the language of the ancient aboriginals of the island.
Yep.
You are not going to believe it, Craig.
No. Nope.
But we are in the St. Jack's Way.
Okay.
I tell you, this is the only St. Jack's Way. Remember Camino de Santiago?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Outside the mainland, right?
Uh-huh.
Because the legend said there was this people traveling, sailing alongside the coast of Gran Canaria, and they had troubles out at large on the sea, and they promised if we ever save our lives, we will pay tribute to Saint Jacques, and we have this special moment when Gran Canaria became part of the Saint Jacques Way, starting in San Bartolomé Tirajana up to the north
Okay.
Ancient capital of the city called Galdar, right? Yeah. It's a very special place.
Nice.
It's a popular location for visitors in the way to the mountains in Gran Canaria.
Amazing, cool. And that's where we're going to go now. We're going to go back to the mountains.
Now we keep going up the mountains to the highlands of Gran Canaria.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Let's go.
Let's go for that.
Vamos.
Yes.
To Gran Canaria right now. Introduce yourself.
Well, so my name is Marina. I'm coming from Gran. I'm living in Gran Canaria, but coming from France. I came here 8 years ago with my family in holidays, and I totally fell in love with this beautiful island and beautiful paradise.
What made you fall in love with Gran Canaria?
First, I think all the contrast of this beautiful island. It's very, very small island on the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. But for the people, or they have the opportunity to see and to cross the island, they can really realize all the contrast what we have on this very small area. Gran Canaria, one of the name of Gran Canaria is the mini continent, because it's full of canyon, full of microclimate, and obviously the landscape is changing in every kilometers. So Gran Canaria is a mini continent with beautiful landscape, very different landscape all around the island, and I think that is one of the most beautiful things of this beautiful island, and the local people. Very friendly, they love to share, and local people don't have a lot of things, but they have a lot of love to share.
They certainly do, and you've summed up the island perfectly as the way I've felt about it when I visited on my holidays in January. Now, we're on an incentive right now as part of a farm trip organised through the Gran Canaria Convention Bureau, and loving what we're doing in terms of the jeeps through the island. So explain, like, in terms of the incentives of the island as a destination for people coming here for trips.
I think first, if you look at the weather, just the land, the weather can speak by himself. I mean, we are on the 15th of December and it's 22 degrees. We are in Europe. So I think that is one of the first incentives of the Canaries Island, where you can enjoy a very beautiful winter, where you can be with swimming suites in winter in Europe.
Just to let people know right now that we have seen Christmas lights and Christmas jumpers today.
Yeah.
So you've certainly hit the nail on the head there. Absolutely. Tell us more about the activity we're on just now.
About?
The activity that we're on just now.
The activity?
Yeah.
Well, on this company we have different kind of activity, but every activity are going inside the island to one more time show all the most beautiful things, because Gran Canaria is not just thousands of hotels on the coast. We have beautiful touristic area, but Gran Canaria is also all of this natural part. And you just look how amazing is this area with full of canyon, quite deep, and again all this diversity about plant, color, rocks, volcanic formation, natural pools on the coast, sand dunes. So really Gran Canaria is not just a touristic area, and I'm very happy, because after COVID we start to change a bit the kind of tourism. And now it's not just a massive tourist, or they just go on the touristic area. We have also a lot of active tourism, where people, they go all around the island, and that kind of people, they can really say what is Gran Canaria, because one more time, it's not just thousands of hotels on the coast.
I'm just looking out at these views, it's absolutely incredible what we're seeing, you know, so amazing. Certainly a place to recommend for coming out to visit and explore and see so many different areas. Merci, gracias.
De nada. Hasta pronto.
Hasta luego. Good place to take a photo.
Yeah, it's a beautiful shot.
I must never get bored of this.
Oh yeah, we have a beautiful setting here. It's amazing, we are in Tejeda now.
Nice.
Tejeda is one of the most popular stops for visitors in the highlands, in the mountains of Gran Canaria. We are having the opportunity to see one of the geological symbols of the island. It's called Roque Bentayga. If you climb up to the top, it's a short trek in about, 30 minutes. You go up there, and there is a beautiful place of adoration of the ancient inhabitants of the island, the ancient Canario people. They were up there adoring. It was a place of religious spirit up there. And now you can see the footprints of this beautiful location with a nice view over this ancient volcano, which was what's remaining out of a mountain which was 2,500 meters above sea level. I'm talking about a big, big, big crater left by this mountain that collapsed back in the days. We're talking about millions of years here in Gran Canaria.
Have you ever climbed that?
I have, and it's beautiful. Yeah. But remember, we are now 1,500 meters above sea level. Yeah. It can be quite chilly in the winter time when you are here up in the mountains, right? But people, they are sunbathing and swimming while you are in the coast, right? This is a variety of landscapes.
It's very much the microclimate. Even coming up in the car, the Jeep there, it we just is. Felt like, just as soon as we came round the mountain, I was like, oh, get the hoodie on, you know? And it's just, it's amazing to see the difference from obviously down on the beach and then right up here to the green hills and learning about the almonds and the nature that's coming into that season, and then this massive crater.
There is this warm sense of hospitality up here in the mountains. Totally. Very friendly atmosphere, and the food is amazing here.
You can smell that just by passing that restaurant and the tastes of the shop and the bakery there. Fantastic. Mm-hmm.
This is Tejeda. It's shortlisted in the Spanish list of most beautiful villages in Spain, Tejeda, right? And then we are in the heart of the World Heritage area known as the Sacred Mountains of Gran Canaria. We are talking about this cultural landscape where Roque Bentayga and Roque Nublo up there are part of the, say, most important icons. We are talking about UNESCO protected territory here in Gran Canaria, World Heritage.
Amazing.
Reserve of the biosphere by UNESCO. Like nearly 50% of the island is protected in some way.
Yeah. Beautiful place. Let's go and explore. The beauty of Gran Canaria now very much plain to see, having transferred ourselves through the middle of the island, this is such a beautiful place to put on events. Though, we did have a bit of an issue when we started moving again.
Traffic jam in Gran Canaria.
Getting to enjoy the nature and the island on these single track roads was a really authentic experience, one which brought a lot of laughs to the journey.
Well, that's it, guys.
Many years people have travelled to Gran Canaria to get to the seaside, to enjoy the beach, the sunshine, and lots more, and that's where we decide to take our journey next, to go out and explore on the kayaks and some snorkeling, see some beautiful, beautiful scenery. Let's take a walk through the beach of Las Palmas.
Sergio,
enjoying
the sunshine on the beach.
Amazing, what do you think?
Have you been surfing?
Been surfing. Convention center.
Amazing, how was it?
It's a traffic jam here.
Over here?
Yeah. I'm pointing over towards the Las Palmas Convention Center. How many do you know that have a beach outside? January when I first fell in love with the beach on Las Palmas, this beautiful stretch of sand right beside the city. I just thought it was so cool with people going out playing volleyball, people out in the restaurants along the strip. Just a fantastic place to come and relax, to think, with such great facilities nearby.
Sergio's now going to explain some facts about Gran Canaria.
Full urban beaches here in Spain. I should say, we have these excellent weather conditions. We share UK time. We have that 1 hour less than mainland Spain. You are 1 hour younger than the rest of the Spanish community.
That means we're not failed yet.
Then, this city is, the first Japanese restaurant in Spain opened in Las Palmas de Gran Canaria back in the 60s because of the port industry Japanese fleet being located here. Also the first IKEA shop.
But IKEA in Spain?
IKEA is Swedish shop. First IKEA was opened. Vessels coming from all corners of the whole world, and this makes the society of Gran Canaria very cosmopolitan and open-minded. You should bear in mind that right morning to be here is February. We have the carnival, which is amazing, both in Las Palmas de Gran Canaria and Las Palomas, and then each village has a small carnival, which is super, super fun.
Thank you for sharing the facts.
I'm here to give you more tips, so keep connected to Gran Canaria
Convention. Shall we go and watch the football?
Yes.
That's good. Let's have a go. Let's do it.
Amarillos, the nickname of Las Palmas, the football team of Gran Canaria. I'm so excited to be back in this football stadium. Always made feel very, very welcome in Las Palmas, and I just thought the game was great. Okay, sad about the equaliser at the end, but a great goal scored by the team. But one thing I do want to talk about, you took me down to see the ultras after I'm talking about how good the atmosphere was.
Ultras.
Tell me about the fans.
This group was created back in 1985, so they've been with us for quite a
1 year younger than me.
Even in the hard times, they've always been there, always supporting and following the group. The yellow players, all around mainland Spain, in all the stadiums, it doesn't matter which division they're playing, they're always there. Up or down, we are always there.
Absolutely.
And it's the soundtrack of the stadium.
Yep.
It's these guys, it's all ages supporting group. Las Palmas, local team is back in Primera División after a number of years in the second division. We are back on the top, which is historically, environment. You know, we've been with this edition like 35 years in Primera División. We are so happy about it. It's so happy moment for Las Palmas. We are doing well. We are doing well. We are about to end up the year and the first half of the competition in the top 10, up in the top half of the
table,
which is wonderful for us. You know, after being promoted back in Primera División. And well, the game was okay. First half was great, was ours. Possession was all ours. I enjoyed some of the best minutes in the league so far for Las Palmas, for the yellow side. And then on the second half, we suffered a lot. The injury of Alberto Moleiro, a gifted player from the Canary Islands, playing for Las Palmas, even though he was born on the neighboring island of Tenerife, right? Same as Kirian Rodriguez. On the 4th of January, to start the year, we have Football Club Barcelona visiting the Gran Canaria Stadium, which is going to be a huge celebration. People coming from all the islands and overseas, mainland Spain, from all corners of Europe, coming to see this amazing game, Las Palmas against Barcelona, a demonstration of the Canarian football.
After a joyous afternoon at the football into the early evening, I weirdly, randomly met one of my sister's next door neighbours at the game. It's amazing. We decided we were going to head up Rocky Nobo and watch the sunset. You can just see it there in the distance. Beautiful, beautiful surroundings in nature, and very, very excited to be up the top here, overlooking the island right out to Tenerife, and watching the beautiful, beautiful nature of the middle of Gran Canaria. I thoroughly recommend that you do this trip, taking a group up here to see the absolute beauty of the island from the middle. Just look at these views.
Sunset at the end, yeah?
Well, it's to you, Sergio.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The experience I'll never forget at the top of that mountain with a group of friends overlooking that beautiful, beautiful sunset. I mean, come on, look at this. Unbelievable scenes. Well, that was an incredible experience. Now let's head back to the beach for a little while. Gran Canaria is just a phenomenal island. There's so many different things to check out. One thing I've really, really been impressed with is the infrastructure in place to host lots of events. In the south, you've got Melaneres, and you've got your expo centre. Also an expo centre up here in Las Palmas. And I just love like lots of the hotels. Like here we have the Santa Catalina, beautiful five-star property here up in Las Palmas. Down south you've got the Lopesan, you've got the Seaside Collection, you've got many, many more great hotels and facilities on this fantastic Mice Island. Know by now that I love my live music, so it's time to explore the island. Let's go see a Rolling Stones tribute band.
We'll be right back.
very, very fun evening, enjoying the entertainment in the island. And a fantastic venue, the sort of thing we love for events, where you're able to just totally do whatever you like in the space to make it the best event design possible. Currently, you'll see us driving over a bridge that was used in the Fast and the Furious. We're heading to the north of the island. We're actually going for a really nice lunch at a place called Casa Romantica. So we've made it to Agueti Valley in the north of Gran Canaria.
Yep, we are in one of my favorite spots here in Gran Canaria, northwest of the island. It's an amazing place connecting our ocean at the harbor of Puerto de las Nieves and the sacred mountains of Gran Canaria.
And these mountains are absolutely incredible.
Up where the Aboriginals lived in the past, right? And what we have done in this amazing place called Casa Romantica, which is a very nice restaurant, expressing the best of our local gastronomy and presenting it nicely. We have done in this sort of a museum like a journey around across the 21 different municipalities in Gran Canaria. Do you want to have a look?
I think that'd be a great idea. And let's see if we can run through the different areas.
It's a journey across the island of Gran Canaria. Let's come in.
Okay. Such a lovely place, and I'm very excited about the lunch that's coming.
Okay, as you see, this is a traditional kitchen. We are in the highest part of the island, in Tejeda. So they are into sugar cane, they are into, well, this is arucas for the sugar cane, for the rum.
Yeah.
Remember, all rums in the Caribbean are descendants of the rums we made before here in Gran Canaria.
And from we the highest points to where we're going now?
Valle Seco is halfway between the sea and the mountains, and they produce apples and they make gold medal winners cider from Valle Seco.
Nice.
They have very, very good reputation and they get international awards, right? So we come this way and we get to Galdar, which is the first city, the first capital city of Gran Canaria.
And it has so nice seeing that on the mountain.
Oh yeah, it has a lot to do with the Aboriginals. Yeah. It was the first, the ancient capital city of Gran Canaria. In this case, we are in San Nicolás de Tolentino. As you see, we are here in the far west, and they have a very good reputation for agriculture, tomatoes, and also, as you see here, tobacco. Moya, again, halfway between the northern coast and the mountains. They have a passion for pastries. They make excellent desserts there in Moya. And then we have Ingenio, which is a handcrafts capital city of Gran Canaria. And they also have passion for gofio making. Ingenio. Ingenio comes from the Portuguese word engenho, which is the place where you cook the sugar cane to produce sugar. Remember, these islands were called the sugar islands. Yeah. Very important. Look at these beautiful prehistoric symbols of the ancient Canario people.
What do we have here? We have Teror and we have...
Teror is a place to go on the 8th of September. Everyone in Gran Canaria is thinking of Teror, is going there. We are talking about pilgrimage, adoration to a patron virgin, Nuestra Señora del Pino.
Nice.
It's the moment of great expression of devotion for a patron virgin, Nuestra Señora del Pino. Look at this beautiful dragon tree endemic from this region, Macaronesia, Azores, Madeira, Cape Verde, and the Canary Islands.
Beautiful. I was hearing about the dragon trees. It was when the daughter was born, you would plant the dragon tree.
Yep.
Tradition,
The dragon tree, you know, they have this reddish sap, which is very good for your body. It has a medical properties.
Oh, this is one
of my favourites by the looks of it.
Okay, we are probably one of the most touristic municipalities in Spain. San Bartolomé de Tirajana is Maspalomas, is Playa del Inglés, but it goes up to the very top of the mountains where you see San Bartolomé de Tirajana, the capital city, which is in the way of San Jacques, the way which goes from San Bartolomé de Tirajana to the Church of Santiago de los Caballeros in Galdar, where you get the Compostelana, as you have like achieved the success in the San Jacques way.
Nice.
Yep, as it happens in the original Camino de Santiago, because this is one real Camino de Santiago outside mainland Spain.
That was amazing, seeing that yesterday.
Camino Santo de Gran Canaria, amazing. San Jacques way in Gran Canaria.
The olive oil as well.
Olive oil is also very limited production, but it is a great, great quality.
Nice.
Telde is very famous for its oranges, and it was second important city in the old Aboriginal times.
Nice.
El Faicanato de Telde. And we come to Mogan, which is all about subtropical produce. Mangoes, number one, avocado, number one, and all sorts of subtropical fruits you may imagine. Tamarindo, pineapple, we have kiwis. It's the place with one of the most amazing patterns of weather all year round.
Wow.
By the way, Las Palmas de Gran Canaria is the city with the best climate in the world.
Oh, it's unbelievable.
Yep.
It really is incredible, especially today.
Oh, yes, we have here a moment of remembrance of tribute to the great Tomás Morales. He's a local writer, writing loads of novels.
Yep.
And he used to live in this house
during
his life.
Yep.
And we remind him here is a museum to his memory.
Amazing.
And beautiful work.
Fantastic.
Tomás Morales, the poet of Gran Canaria. And this is it. We have hard work in the old times linked to the agriculture, to taking care of the cattle. This is a wool made with the hands of the women and men in the old times to make all sort of traditional blankets used in our daily life. You know, it's Gran Canaria is a tradition, modernity, all together in this round-shaped island.
It's really great to see the traditions coming through and being part of the crafts, which would make for a very, very good incentive as well.
Yep.
For people to come and help.
We have the spaces, we have the professionals, we have all what you need to get the best bits of a holiday destination with many, many years of experience into the meetings industry.
Amazing.
We have a number of successful events. This year has been very good, and we want you, meeting planners from all over the world, to think of Gran Canaria as a very exotic destination within the European borders, where you can organize all sorts of events all year round.
Amazing.
With nice weather.
Perfect.
What do you think?
I love it. And we've just done a tour of Gran Canaria in around 5 minutes, and we've learned so much. Again, a fountain of knowledge. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Let's go have some lunch.
It's a pleasure. And now let's go
eat.
Let's go eat.
Perfect.
Yes.
The food scene in the island is absolutely spectacular. Danger of changing this into a sort of Instagram page whilst I showcase some of the great food we had on the island. This is currently in Casa Romantica. I fell in love with the food in Spain many, many years ago, and there is so much great restaurants to try out, so many great taste sensations. Look at this tapas, for example. So cheap as well. Fantastic flavours. Listen to the sound of the prawns. Wow. The tortilla, the best on the island. Unbelievable. And personal favourite in Gran Canaria, the mojo, the potatoes with the mojo. Let's not forget the Spanish wine. There's plenty of it. And Sergio mentioned, there's a lot of rum to go around. Why not have that with some chocolate? you're like me and like to keep active, it's certainly the best way to work off that food. Get on the beach, get some volleyball, get some tennis, get some paddling, go for a swim. It's time now to wrap up our experience in Gran Canaria. So good to be back on the island, understanding the very much the difference in the diversity of the island and the different climates and the amazing locations we have for events. Massive, massive thank you has to go to Sergio Maccanti for showing me the island. What an incredible human being, the fountain of knowledge of so much stuff in the island. Absolutely perfect to show us round. Much, much appreciated. Muchas gracias, mi amigo. Another thing that stood out for me was the arts and crafts in the island, and it was great to come here and see the sand sculptures before we headed over to the Christmas market. See the clothes, the jewellery, the crafts. So much of that, so much sustainable products being produced here, certainly worth looking at. Lots of opportunities for sustainable events, especially in Melon areas where they have the expo centre within walking distance of all the hotels. So much of the products on this island are created on the island, and you really have to get involved and try. Gran Canaria for me is a very, very special place in my heart, and I'm so proud that I've had the opportunity to have went a couple of times. If you haven't been, thoroughly recommend you get yourself along. Fantastic location, fantastic destination, fantastic weather, fantastic people, fantastic food. It's certainly high up on my list for future events. At Panoptic Events, we aim to constantly create world-class experiences for you around the world. We've placed events across three continents. We are more than happy to talk to you about your future MICE events. The sun sets on another fantastic trip, just to say, wow, what a great experience. Loved that we could learn so much in such a short period of time. I hope you take something from the video and you understand how much we love the Gran Canaria. Let's quickly meet the team on our first documentary.
What? Why me now?
It's you. You cold?
Yeah, I'm cold.
Introduce yourself.
Hello. Why? Why should I do it right now? I'm Kseniia, the one, Photoshop surfer.
Thank you so much to our Photoshop surfer camera lady. What a job you did. Thank you very much.
Yep. Shall we finish on a song?
Señores, yo soy canario y tengo aguante. Yo sigo a Unión Deportiva por todas partes. ¿Por qué? Porque es un sentimiento que se lleva en el corazón. Yo daría toda la vida por ser campeón. Soy canario, soy canario, soy canario, soy canario. Unión Deportiva Las Palmas, arriba de ello!
Gracias, Sergio.
Gracias a ti.
And I've been Craig McGee, a lover of travel, learning from other cultures, reading, cycling, swimming, keeping active, and meeting lots of people. Thank you so much for listening. We'd love you to subscribe, add some comments, share the video, let me know your thoughts on Gran Canaria. Your support is massively appreciated. Hasta luego.